There are lots of different AI apps out there, especially in note-taking, and this one caught my attention and impressed me from day one, which is very rare. So today we're gonna look at an application called Recall AI. You can find it linked below, and if you're interested in it, you can explore it further there. But we're gonna overview everything you need to know about this software. So today's video is kindly sponsored by Sensama. You can find a little bit more about them later into this video. So Recall AI landed on my desk because I was checking out AI Chrome extensions, and I found it, and I thought, actually, this is fairly good. And I sort of explored it a bit more in detail. Now, it is a very interesting application because it's sort of a two-parter. It's got a note-taking experience, but then it's also got an augmented browser experience. I'm not going to be reviewing that part in this video. That sounds like a little bit more depth, but it's well worth checking out because it comes part of Recall, and I guess I should be, but I don't think I have the expertise to talk about browsers just yet. So I'm going to zoom in on the note-taking part that impressed me. And this application is available on iOS. I believe it has another mobile application on Android, and I'll include all of the pricing details below as well. But it's priced at a fairly reasonable $7 per user per month, billed annually, which again, isn't mad, especially when you look at what's included as part of this. So inside of the free plan, you get 10 AI uses, but really the premium is where you unlock unlimited access. So you can take a YouTube video, podcast, article, or whatever it may be, paste it into Recall, and essentially from here, you'll be able to interact with that, say, YouTube video. For example, what it's going to do is it's going to create a summary, but also allow you to add your own notes to the same document, if that makes sense. And as you can see, it's pretty easy. You get all of the regular text formatting options, and it doesn't stop quite there. You can use the chat modes to essentially add elements to the notebook as you chat to the function, which is very, very helpful. So you can continue to narrow down your options based on what you've learned as part of that video. Now, there are additional features here as well. So for example, they have three things that could be helpful. A quiz, which turns all of the insights as part of the video into a quick quiz that you can help follow. So this can be perfect for studying, flashcards, and just expanding on your thoughts a little bit further. For example, you could even turn a journal entry into a quiz, asking yourself questions and narrowing down your options, which could be pretty cool. And you can start your review and also monitor how all of your flashcards work as well. There are two additional features that are quite interesting: connections and graph. Graph is just a visual representation of how notes connect, but there's this connections feature, which is pretty cool. So every time a YouTube video is connected, it's gonna help turn each of those into a profile. Like this video, for example, Antonio Fuoco, Italian racing driver. If I click into it, what it will do here is it will create a card or a person, which means I can take notes on that person. But I can also hit this button up in the top right-hand corner to expand it out and take some AI insights that are available, which will help me to build a profile on that person. Now I can do the same thing. I can create a quiz, see the connections, or a graph view. But this means this person is now saved into my notebook. You don't have to have that. You can delete that. But what's different is you can start seeing an expansion of your notes. And what's nice as well is each of the types of tags that they give each of the people or notes will be able to organize themselves on the left-hand side. So there's no excessive manualization to this unless you want there to be. So you don't just have to limit yourself to creating stuff that's already been created from Wikipedia and things like that, but you can actually use a notebook which has all of the functions. You've got highlighter function, image function, and the ability to create a quiz or a connection or a graph from this. And in the top right hand corner, you can share this, export it to Markdown, or see any images, which is pretty good. So today's video is sponsored by Sensama. Sensama is a powerful, mindful task management software, and it's really popular for those who want to stand back and plan their day more effectively. There's guided planning, reflection upon each of the days that you complete, and great systems in place to help you focus, but also make sure you're not stuffing your calendar and task management with lots and lots of tasks. So check out Sensama below, and thanks for those guys for sponsoring today's video. So I was fairly impressed that this functionality was available in there. And to be honest, there's less of these type of applications around. The closest I've probably seen is obviously capacities, but you sort of have to create your own object system, and there's not a reliance on the web search element of this. I was struggling to actually find similar alternatives this application in the wild. So what you can do is you can continue to expand that and bring together insights. Now, some of the stuff I didn't like about this app is that if you plug something, you have to go and change the image for it, which I think is a little bit sort of janky as a process. And I wasn't too impressed with the layout of this in terms of the side. I didn't like the titles they gave it. Although you can obviously go in and change your title, it sort of felt very AI centric. Sometimes that's helpful. Sometimes it feels a little bit overwhelming and probably something you would probably change over time. But maybe in the future, there'll be a prompt to create something or a structure that you typically like. Now, moving on to the recall review side of stuff, you can go and see and monitor the questions and the quizzes that you have in real time. So you can go into that process, which is perfect for studying and narrowing down your options. You can also see a graph view and monitor stuff there. Now, one of the things I quite liked about this app is the Chrome extension worked very well. I was able to clip and organize stuff pretty easily, and I wasn't really worried about the organization because it was done for me, which was really good. So as a whole, this application did a good job of bringing stuff together, and I quite like the home view that they create for this. So who is this application best for? It's quite a tricky one. Obviously, students are going to benefit from the flashcards, and being able to take the intensity out of a flashcard could be quite helpful. For example, if you chatted with the particular note, like for example, say it was James Scott here, and you wanted to be able to learn about some of his stuff, you could then use this chat with it and narrow down your options to help it be a little bit more extensive and focused towards a particular thing that James Scott has done in his lifetime. And then what you can do is obviously create a quiz from that, which will help you to better correlate the cards to your results, which could be incredibly helpful. And I do like the fact that it did capture the YouTube videos quite well in a summary inside of this note-taking application, which helped to break things down even further. Here's a good example of that. They created a section on sport, but then a section on motorsport to organize the Ferrari video saved, which I quite liked because it doesn't quite overwhelm it. So all in all, this application is probably best for students, for those who really are reliant on research as part of their note-taking, or that those want who want a YouTube summary and to be able to combine their note-taking in it together. So it's a really interesting application when it comes to that. And I think it's a strange one. It doesn't really fit fully in the market right now, but it is an interesting AI application for taking notes. So thank you so much for stopping by. Thanks to Sansama for sponsoring today's video. I hope it was helpful, and I hope that Recall is an interesting app for you of choice. So impressive one for me, and I'll see you in a future video, I'm sure. Cheerio for now.